Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Jason Ryan for Hollywood TV, and we're at the TCL Chinese Theater for the Hollywood premiere of San Andreas, starring Dwayne Johnson.
You know, we wanted to make a movie that was big and entertaining, and especially in a genre that few movies are actually made in, when you look at it in the grand scheme of things, compared to horror movies or action movies, so we wanted to make a movie that was big and entertaining, but also make sure that it was rooted in some authenticity. We had the great seismologist, leading seismologist, and earthquake scientist pour over our script to help us with the script, and when you watch the movie, it's a powerful film. Number one, I want them to be entertained. It is truly a relentless movie, and people around the world, since we've been showing the movie, have really responded in a positive way. I mean, really, it's relentless, it's intense, it's a ride. It is a hell of a ride.
I'm gonna get you out!
And also, too, I think there's the preparedness aspect of it, and make sure that there's great education that you pull from it, because I thought, as a family, we were prepared. I thought, as a man, I was prepared, and I thought I knew about earthquake and science and fact. But it wasn't until I made the movie and spent time with the scientists and seismologists that I understand on a greater level now, and just how powerful Mother Nature is, and that we're 100 years overdue. And so the best thing we could do is live our life and be as prepared as possible.
Do you have a plan in case there is an earthquake by any chance?
You know, once I started writing and researching this movie, I definitely made a plan. I got myself water purifier, found someone, you're supposed to find someone outside of the city of LA or out of California that everybody you know and care about should talk to, have a landline phone. Yeah, I picked up a lot of tips talking to earthquake experts.
When you were doing the research for this, did it scare you when you started to realize the magnitude of what could really happen?
It actually did. Yeah. I mean, I think all of us in California, we live in some form of denial about earthquakes. You know, we think, well, it's not really going to happen to me, or it's not going to be that bad. But once I started talking to people about it and realized it's not really a question of, you know, if, it's really a question of when, that I took getting ready a little bit more seriously.
This movie's got a lot of big stunts in it. You're used to doing stunts on The Arrow. What was the difference between doing TV stunts and these big movies?
Well, I don't really do a lot of them. So I think the difference is just being even more scared than before. But I did get sick on this movie, but it was the easiest experience of my life. It was just the coolest thing, and working with a cast like this is just mind-blowing.
There's a lot of big special effects scenes in this movie. Which one was the most trying for you to shoot?
The water tank work was very difficult for me to do. At one point they suck all the water up into these giant dump tanks, and they sort of tie you to a pillar, and then they drop it on you, and you get, you know, thrown by the weight of the water, which is a very, it's nice that you don't have to fake it. You're actually experiencing what the character's experiencing, but it was nerve-wracking. I've never done anything quite like that before.
Don't you quit on me!
I'd be safe and warm if I was an animal.